Hello, I'm Dr. Yothin Chinwarun from Bangkok, from Thailand. What I'm going to present is about PET imaging and the spec in epilepsy. FDG PET imaging remains important tool in localization of ectal onset zone, seizure propagation pathway, and functional deficit zone in the physical evaluation of the patient with refractory partial epilepsy. The value of the PET for localization has been firmly established. For patients with temporal epilepsy and extratemporal epilepsy, it has invaluable role in research into the epileptogenesis or to identify underlying cause. The severity of the FDG PET in temporal epilepsy is high, up to 80 to 90% to identify focal of seizure onset. However, the localization of the seizure foci in extratemporal epilepsy is more difficult than the temporal epilepsy. PET was proposed as reflecting the functional deficit zone rather than the representing the epileptogenic zone. In spite of this, there is still a good correlation of functional deficit zone and a good lateralization. As a result, in case with a good lateralization of the PET study with the other imaging modality show a better surgical outcome. With multimodal approach, PET is one of useful imaging modality help to provide objective result. PET is also used to evaluate the specific receptor system likely to become important in the future and may provide insight and understanding of complex mechanism of refractory epilepsy. It could be used to study development and termination of seizure. Ectal spec about to demonstrate ectal neuronal activation and non-invasive marker of ectal onset zone. It is particularly useful in MRI negative partial epilepsy and focal cortical dysplasia. Interpretation of the ectal spec confirmed by propagation of ectal activity and early switch from ectal hyperperfusion to postictal hypoperfusion during brief seizure, which can be minimized by early ectal spec injection. Interpretation of ectal spec image should always be done in the context of a full pre-surgical evaluation by using subtraction ectal spec technique, co-register with the MI scan, SISCOM method, improve the localization area of hyperperfusion, statistical parametric mapping, analysis of ectal and interectal spec, different image of the select group of the patient, promising method, highlight the region of significant hyper and hypoperfusion, which may provide new insight, pathophysiology of the seizure.